Hey, what's up? It's Beat by Bree. I'm back with a very exciting two-part video. The first part is going to be a pink-themed makeup look using the Pat McGrath Labs Mothership Subversive La Vie en Rose. I'm probably saying that wrong, but this palette right here. The shades are very pretty, and we are going to look inside. So we have these shades here. I think I'm gonna focus on this one, maybe this and this, because we wanna do kind of a pink overall theme today, because in my second part of the video, I'm going to be using the Gypsy Shrine pink unicorn face jewels and Gypsy Shrine glitter to show you how I would do my festival glitter. And yeah, that's exciting. That'll be my first jewels glitter video. So that will be following this one. I will link it in the description below after it comes out. And let's just get started. So I already have my base on. I did not set with powder because I want to maybe put some liquid products on. I did my brows and a little bit of eyeshadow primer. Okay, so jumping right in, we are going to pick up a brush. We're gonna pick up a Sephora Pro Featherweight Crease number 38 here, a little fluffy brush. And I'm just going to set my eyeshadow primer with some MAC white shadow. This is in the color Blanc Type. So we have this shadow here. Ooh, as I drop it, I drop everything. So I'm just gonna swirl into the powder, tap off the excess, and we're just gonna apply this over the whole lid up to, let me pat off the creasing already of the primer. Okay, so try it again. So just kind of patting on the whole lid, just swirl around all the way up to the brow bone. This will help apply a nice base for the shadow to stick to help make it blend out easier. I'm really not trying to be very precise with this. It's pretty, I mean, it has a little bit of a white pigment to it, but I like this as a, to set the primer. You can really use whatever you want though. Just kind of like a neutral skin tone shade. On my face, lipstick or something. Okay, so with that in place, we're gonna move on to the next shade. I think I'm gonna jump in. I have a couple other purple shades here. I have a lot of purple makeup. What do we wanna do here? Let's jump into the Pat McGrath palette, and we're gonna go for this darker shade right here. I'm not sure what it's called, honestly. But we're going to go with this purple right here, and we're going to put this into the crease using a Morphe M441 little tapered blending brush or crease brush. Just swirl into the powder, tap off the excess, and lightly place. Again, I'm going to go a little bit above my crease just because of my hooded eyes so we can see the makeup that I'm putting down. I'm just applying a light layer to start to kind of build up the pigment, and then we can always add more depending on the payoff that we're looking for. Just kind of back and forth motions. I like to go eye by eye, so I apply a little bit here and then I move on to the next eye, look at what I'm working with, and then kind of adjust from there. Just looking straight ahead with my brush, trying to hold it like at a 90 degree angle to my eye. To really be more precise with where the pigment goes. You know the drill. Just kind of sketching out that shape. A little higher on this side. All right, so let's go in and kind of deepen up that pigment. Starting with the outer corner. Just working my way in a corner. Again, I'm barely touching the tip of the brush to my skin. I'm really trying to hold it. You know, you don't want to dab it into your skin and get a whole bunch of shadow in one place. It'll be really hard to blend out that way. Just kind of sketching out what I want here. And move to the other side. Can see what I'm kind of sketching out, just to just following a little bit above my crease. kind of look down a little bit, really kind of deepen up in the crease. I like to slowly build up the pigment versus going in with like a heavy hand and a lot on your brush, and then you're just stuck with trying to blend out for way too long. So if you just slowly build up the color, I feel like it's more controlled, it's easier to work with. Back and forth. Just a little bit more in the crease. And this I'm just trying to get right in my actual crease. Okay. One more time on this side. So that's what we're gonna start with here, looking up, looking down. Now let's move on to, what do I wanna do here? So I have a lighter purple. I don't know, I took it out of the container. I think this is from Smashbox. It's just this bright purple. Again, I don't know what the color is, but I'm going to take this on a smaller blending brush. This is a Morphe M506, just a little bit of a tighter taper. I'm actually gonna put this above, below, we're gonna go above. Just kind of blend the line together of up here. Don't really have a plan on what I'm doing here. I'm just kind of winging it. A lot of purple eyeshadow in front of me, and we'll see what happens. Just kind of bringing that up closer to the brow bone. Same thing on this side. I'm just kind of sketching right along that edge just to add a little bit of color, like transition color. This probably isn't the best brush to do this with, but so I don't know if that even made a difference. With that, I'm gonna take a blending brush. I'm gonna take a Sephora Pro Blending number 27, which is just a little more dense of a brush. And I'm just gonna lightly blend those two shades together. Just in circular motions. Back and forth. Oh, and I don't have under eye concealer on yet, just in case there's any fallout. I do have a little bit of color corrector on, the Becca color corrector, so we'll put concealer on after we're done with our eyes, in case anyone was wondering. Just trying to get a nice even color. Back and forth. I feel like right here is a little darker, but that's fine. Okay, so next we are going to do, what color do we want here? Thinking. Okay, we're gonna use a ColourPop shadow. And I'm going to take it on this Sephora number 56 bullet crease brush here. I'm gonna take this ColourPop shadow, I don't know the name of it, but it's like a pink, a purpley kind of reflective shade. I'm gonna put this in the outer corner. Just kind of swirl it on, tap it off. Let's see how this goes. Just right in the outer V. So up from the eyelid and then right in here. See if I can get some on the brush. just kind of stamping out that outer V. It's really hard, having a hard time on the brush. Let me wipe this shadow off and see if that helps. All right, let's try this again. I might need something a little darker there, but. I think I'm gonna put something a little darker there. We'll do it on this side though. Looking down, so your outer V would be just right here up from your eyelid. And then this shadow is really kind of light. Just kind of drag it across. I'm going to go for a little bit of this bright purple shade right here. Just a touch. See if that helps. And then just kind of dragging it through my crease, whatever's left over on my brush. I know it looks crazy right now, but just give it a minute. I guess I can put this ColourPop shadow down, like holding it in my hand. Just kind of swirling it in the outer corner. Or outer V. Okay. So with a little bit of pigmentation there, let me just blend that out with a Morphe M433. Same thing. Clean it off a little bit. Just kind of swirling lightly in the outer corner. Just blend that together. Drag it across the crease. Okay. So this is what we're working with. Okay, now for the lid, I was going to use another ColourPop shadow, but I'm afraid it's not going to show up. Let's just give it a try. So this is like a pink shimmery ColourPop. I made a mess. Hold on. It's kind of hip pan, but you can see what kind of shade I'm hoping for. Let me take a Sephora, no, a smaller one. Let's use this. This is a Morphe M124. It's a little flat packing brush. I'm gonna dip it, actually, let's do it with my finger. Just kind of rubbing into the shadow. It's very dry. I think I've had this for a minute. And just kind of pat it on the lid. Yeah, this is really dry. It's pretty though. Just kind of pat and drag to help press the shadow in. I have a little bit of fallout here since that shadow is so crumbly. All right, let's do it on our eye. a little bit more. It's really pressing it into the lid and then kind of dragging to help press it down. That makes sense. A little more on this side. Okay. Let me take a clean blending brush. Let's use the Sephora Pro Blending 27. Clean it off. And just kind of blend these two shades together. Small circular motions, really light pressure. I guess this is more of a purple themed look than pink, but it's okay. I like it. Let's see what we're working with. Okay, so let's do a little bit of nude shadow just to blend right here at the brow bone. This is the Makeup Forever single shadow. I'm just gonna take it on a Morphe 562, a little kind of little tiny crease brush. I don't know if this is a blending brush or a crease brush, but I'm just gonna take it right up here at the brow bone. I'm going to take a different brush, actually. Let's actually use... Let's use this brush. This is the Sephora 38. That's better. Just to help blend it out. Same thing on this eye. I'm really not even being that precise. This shadow's pretty close to my skin tone, so I'm not really that worried. I'm just kind of helping to blend the edges a little. Okay, so moving on, let's put a little bit of highlight at the brow bone. To do that, I'm just gonna use the Sephora, I don't even know what this is called. It's like a little precision, a little bullet. This is going to be just kind of a pinky highlight. I think this was from Urban Decay. Again, I took it out of the packaging and put it in my Z palette, but I'm just gonna run this along the brow bone. And same thing on this eye. Just kind of blend that together with the Morphe 433. Because I'm doing the festival look, the glitter after this, I did do more of like a dramatic shadow. This probably isn't an everyday wear shadow, but just to be a little more dramatic, whatever. Okay, so I did get a little bit of fallout because of that ColourPop shadow, so I'm just gonna brush it off with a Sephora Pro Contour number 79, the little fluffy brush. And then let's do concealer and we'll do our under eye shadow. So for concealer, I'm going to be using the NARS Soft Matte Complete Concealer in shade medium 1 Custard. Looking like this here. Take it on my Sephora Airbrush Shadow. I just got this on my shirt now. Number 30, a little flat brush here. Just dip into the pot and kind of sketch out my under eye. I usually start with the darkest first, just in kind of like patting motions. Take it a little bit up into the inner corner. Hope to cut that eyeshadow where I want it to go. And then I'm gonna drag it a little bit down my cheek. And we're gonna blend this out with the beauty sponge. So, like so. Okay, same thing on the other side. Just patting it in place. Ah, that was too much. I'll put down the nose. Of course, my eye. It wouldn't be a makeup video without my eye watering. All right, now I'm gonna take my beauty sponge. This is the Sephora, angled brush or a sponge. I'm gonna take the flat edge here and just press this into this, bounce this into the skin. I like to work back and forth. I don't know, some people do one and then the other. Cut the eyeshadow. Bit on the shadow. How about this side? Okay, so concealer on. Moving on with my watering eye. Let's kind of set the under eye just a tiny bit with a little bit of powder. We're gonna be using the MAC Studio Fix in shade NW15, right here. Just dip in with my Morphe E20 brush, and I'm gonna lightly pack a little bit of shadow underneath just to set the under eye. And on the next. Okay. All right, let's do under eye. What is it called? Eyeshadow. Or a bottom eyeshadow. I have no idea what I want to do for the under eye shadow. Let's take, let's take that first shade from the Pat McGrath palette, this purple here, on, what brush do we want? I'm going to take it on this Bullet crease brush, maybe 86. I kind of want more of a blown out look. So let's just take it on this brush. Lightly underneath the eye. Connecting to the eyeshadow on the top. And a little bit on our side. Oh, that was a lot of payoff. That was very pigmented, that swipe. I'm gonna have to recreate that on. Oh, I dipped in the wrong shadow. Shit, that's why. Fuck. All right, let's put this one on this side now. That was that bright purple shade. I dipped into the wrong shadow. That's okay, we can fix it. Unexpected turn of events. I did not mean to do that. Fuck. A little bit of my sponge to clean up that edge now that I just effed up. Let me take where's my brush? This little smudge brush and go into the purple shade I intended and put that under the lower lash line. So keep my nose always running when I'm doing makeup videos. Much more purple than I expected, but that's okay. We're doing festival makeup, so no big deal. Let me just blend that. Blend that bright, unintended purple into the upper eyeshadow. And okay, so I'm gonna take a little bit of the light pink, I think, on, give me a brush, another little tiny smudge brush here. And just kind of put this on the inner corner. Just stamping that on the inner corner. Okay. Let's leave it at that. And let's just put on a little coat of mascara and some lashes. I was gonna do my face in this video, but I feel like it's too long already, so instead of a two-part video, this will be a three-part. The next part will be face, it'll be contour, blush, highlight, and bronzer, and then the third part will be the festival jewels. So just one coat of mascara. Trying not to F it up. Other eye. I'm not a big fan of this mascara wand. I feel like it's too fluffy for me, but it's okay. I have it, so I'm gonna use it. Oh, by the way, this is the Too Faced Better Than Sex mascara. Stop my eye from watering. To do that, I just kind of stick the Q-tip in the inner corner of the eye and just kind of set it there for a minute. Excuse me. Okay, so for lashes, we're going to use, get all the stuff out of the way. the Heiress Silk by Sephora Collection. These are silk lashes in style. Oh, these are in style Heiress. I guess they look kind of like this. These are already cut. I have worn these before. Oh, I just pulled a lash off the end. Shoot. These might be too small. I don't know. This is what we're working with now. Let's see. It'll work. All right, let's get our glue. Where is my glue? Eyelash glue. Where's my lash glue? Oh, I'm sitting on it. Duh. Coat the lash band. This is a really thin lash band. I hope these lashes work. I didn't even like test them out before this. And just coating the lash band with a tiny ribbon of glue. The glue I'm using is the House of Lashes clear glue. Okay. So let this dry for a minute. I don't know, what do you guys think? I definitely didn't mean to put that bright purple under the eye. But again, we're going for this eye look with these face jewels. So I feel like it'll look good. And just sticking the lash. Oh, these are definitely shorter lashes than I had expected, but I'm not really a fan of these lashes, honestly. They're like too short. They like stop right here. Okay, so I'll do lashes off camera. Let me just put another coat of mascara on. I'm not a fan of these lashes. I'm not sure. They look like way too small for my eyes, but they were cut at one point for my eyes. So did my eyes get bigger? I don't know. Let's just do another coat of mascara for fun. I definitely don't like this brush. Okay. A little bit of liner. I'm dropping everything. This is the Pat McGrath Perma Gel Eyeliner, I believe. And just a little in the waterline. I lost the cap, of course. And bottom mascara. Okay, that's it. That is my eye look all complete. Get ready for the Pink Unicorn Face Jewels by the Gypsy Shrine. But the next video, part two, will be the face again. So stay tuned for that. I hope you guys like this eye look. Again, it looks a little crazy now, but just imagine this with this. What do you think? I like it. I like the inner corner a lot. Give you I might not even do lashes. Maybe I will do lashes. I'll just keep talking to myself. It's been 35 minutes already. All right, I'll see you guys in the next video, part two, and then face jewels. I'm so excited. All right, thanks for watching. Don't forget, if you haven't subscribed, I'd love it if you do, or at least hit the like button if you liked this video. Okay, I'll see you guys in part two. Bye. Peace.